Welcome to the Welsh countryside. Rolling green hills, or in this case, white in this photo. All sorts of wildlife and vegetation. And a happy little railway line, which consists of many, many engines. Not normal engines, the ones of steam. Welcome to Somewhere Wales. Some people call it the railway. Others call it a fun little train community. But to most others, it's a bit more than just a simple railway line game. More or less, a full-on community where everyone gets to share their experiences on the rails, wide or narrow. In this case, we look into the lives and minds of the other engines that inhabit the lush green hills of the Welsh countryside. This story takes place in the Welsh countryside we all know and love, starting at Port Andreas, or Andreas Port. The port that sides with the little town of Andreas along the little railway. It's one of the two line's terminuses that you can get on, get off, purchase tickets, or even watch the engines shunt trucks. In my dreams, I'd ride the rails to Big Iron, one of the port's tank engines, has a very special day ahead of him. He gets to pull a large supply train to a redwood logging company. The other engine, the large, tender engine, is Elmira. Let's see how they get along.
Good morning, Elmira!
Good morning, Big Iron. What makes you so happy today?
Did you not hear? Apparently I've got a supply train to head up to Redwood Logging Company. They need more axe parts, I believe.
Axe parts? You crack me up. It's not pronounced axe parts, it's more or less something like saws or axes. Those sort of things.
Or perhaps it's maybe parts for the logging engines up there. I heard John Henry and Eustace work there. Those two Americans.
Oh, don't go blithering yourself with those other American engines. Especially with that black number one engine, Eustace.
Well, what do be the matter with him?
Oh, you haven't heard? Him and I are both tender engines, and I get jealous because I used to be the most prime tender engine on this line. If I mean prime, I mean I'm the best. And I still am the best. I am the express engine, after all.
Didn't Gilbert take up all of your slots on the timetable? Apparently, you were left with only the express while Gilbert's taken everybody else. Why do you think they have new coaches?
Oh, don't bother yourself with that. Oh, I have to get going. It's time to go. Farewell, Big Iron. Good luck on your goods train.
Okay. Goodbye. Well, I don't know if to call that a pleasant conversation or not. Sometime later, Big Iron went over to his goods train and coupled up, ready to depart. But before he departed, he saw his good friend Saltine. Saltine is the smaller green port shunter. Works alongside Big Iron a lot of the time, and they enjoy their company.
Hello, Big Iron. Good to see you here. Do you enjoy that train I coupled to ya?
I really like the effort you put into this, Saltine, but it's pretty heavy to pull. I think I might need a bit of help if I want to get up the higher bits of the hills. Especially since, I'll be going up the steeper gradients, and that switchback over at Redwood.
Really? Huh. I thought John Henry would come down here and collect them. He's usually the freight engine. I wonder what's taking them so long.
Don't worry, there's nothing too big that big iron cannot pull.
I wouldn't advise you to get cocky. Just do remember, those are very steep slopes there. Maybe get a Kid Sparrow engine to help you out with that sort of thing.
I'll be fine. Well, well, Saltine. Have a splendid evening. I'll be back later.
Remember what I said.
And off Big Iron went, with a large supply train, heading up to past Kissboro all the way to Redwood.
You know what? Said Big Iron. I'll take Saltine's advice. And so he did. He drove all the way to Kidsboro to grab another engine, hoping that Ireworth or Quirk would be there. But in fact, Dylan, Quirk, or Ireworth, none of them were there. The only one left behind was Wannabe, who seemed very, very eager to help. Wannabe is a very small engine. In particular, probably even not an engine. It's simply a flatbed with a gasoline engine and a seat on it. We still call them Wannabe because they want to be a diesel.
Hello?
Sanders and smoke boxes. It's the Big Iron. What can I say except welcome? It's been a while since I've seen you.
Perhaps it has been. Listen, have you seen Ireworth, Quirk, or Dylan, perhaps?
Ireworth is up by Quirman's Halt right now. He's picking up passengers for coaches. He's working a Northern Engines line this time. Quirk is in the works. And Dylan's out on a freight run to, God's Keep. I've been the only engine, so I've just been sitting here waiting for my driver to come back. Perhaps I could help you with something?
I don't think I can. I need a rear engine to help me up this line. These crates are already heavy enough as it seems, and they all need to go to Redwood as supplies for every other piece of equipment there. And I'm afraid that you might not be powerful enough to push these cars and with the assistance of me up the hill. I think we both get stuck.
Oh, come on! I promise, I'll be very useful. Plus, two engines are better than one, aren't they?
I guess you are right.
And I promise, I'll be on my best behavior. Okay? Please? I beg of you, it's been forever since I've been out of this yard. It'd be great to go on another adventure, just like little Jimmy Biggins used to bring me on.
Fine. You can come with. Just don't talk me up all the time, okay?
Yes, sir, I promise.
Don't give me any of that, sir, crap, and get behind me.
Oh, sorry, Big Iron. There we go. All set, Big Iron.
All right, Wannabe. Off we go. Hold on tight back there.
And on their way again. This time, it's a duo. The little engine and the flatbed. Really.
But of course, they had a bit of trouble along the way.
Wannabe, speed up. I'm already going as medium speed as I can. A crossing's coming up.
I'm sorry, I'm stalling a bit. Give me a minute.
I can't give you a minute. We're already over the crossing. Just keep going.
Trying!
I thought you said you'd be on your best behavior.
Yeah, well, I didn't say best performance.
I guess you're right. Continue. But eventually, after the fighting in between there and quarry sheds, they eventually made it to a red flag, where Rutley needed to pass by with a load of limestone. And they met Richmond, sitting at the sheds.
Hello, Richmond. How are you?
What? Oh, hello, wannabe. And hello, Big Iron. It's been a while since I've seen you two up here.
What did you think wannabe told me when I picked them up?
Oh, yeah. So, I see you're hauling a goods train. I believe that must be going to Redwood. First supplies, you know.
Wait, what? How did you know?
Wannabe, I'm a very old engine. Of course I'd know what sort of consists are arranged in some sort of order. I've seen that consist many times.
Well, that was right. You did catch that one on spot on. You must be getting wiser as you get older, Richmond. I didn't expect you to be that old. What's your secret in remembering things? Just a quick question.
Work less. The less work you do means the more room you have for the memories that you make.
Doesn't that mean you wouldn't make any more memories?
That's where you're wrong. I have the entire valley out to my view. As I've seen a lot of things. Lots of funny things too. For example, I've seen Romney pass through here like Mach 5, heading down into Quarryman's Hold and derailing there. Luckily, no one was hurt and the drivers were jumped clear. That was a fun day.
Mom, let's go. Romney passed like an hour ago.
Hey, calm down, Munchkin. Okay, might as well pull him along. I'll talk to you later, Richmond. Enjoyed the company and hope you're doing well, old timer. Farewell.
So long, boys, and do be careful. The line is really steep.
And steep it was. They trundled along the old, thin track, only to find out that they are now heading up probably one of the hardest parts of the hill. This bend is very steep, and Big Iron and Wannabe had some troubles on here. One that would be disastrous.
Wannabe, I need some help here.
Alright.
Hey, we're still slowing down. Push harder. He wasn't lying. There we go. Keep pushing, Wannabe.
I'm trying. Big Iron!
What's the matter?
Right there! It's derailed!
Oh, bloody hell! Well, how did that happen?
I don't know. I was pushing like you asked me to. All of a sudden, the brake van went to one side and then fell over.
Fine. Get rid of the brake van. We don't need it for now. This is the last major hill and you can act as my brake van.
You mean second to last?
You know what I meant.
So they have gotten rid of the brake van. They put it onto the side of the hill for another engine to come and grab later. But after they cleared it from the tracks, with one heave and one haul, they were on their way again. And closer than ever.
Eventually, both Wannabe and Big Iron successfully made it to Redwood Halt.
However, Big Iron was very hesitant. He remembered what Elmira told him, and he didn't really want to meet those American engines after all.
Let's hurry up the process, shall we, Wannabe? I don't want to, you know, waste any more time.
Come on, one of my friends lives here.
Which one?
Stay on driving engine, coming on through. Good morning, tank engine, and Wannabe, what you doing up here, buddy?
I would ask the same for you, but you live here. I'm just helping Big Iron here with his load. We brought the redwood supplies you ordered.
You know what? A co-worker of my good friend Wannabe is a co-worker and a friend of mine. Put her there. Oh, wait, I have no hands. I almost forgot.
Nice meeting you too, John or Henry?
You can call me all three. I was named after the legend of John Henry, that steel driving man from the United States who proved to be better than a steam drill before he got ran down in the cave-in incident. Damn, that dude was flatter than a tabletop, I'm telling you that.
that really doesn't sound very pleasant, Mr. Henry. Anyway, I Wannabe, do you think you can take it from here?
Oh yeah, sure. I got it for you, Big Iron. You can head back down now.
Oh, Texas Rangers leaving so soon? Come on, man. Eustace would love to meet you.
I'm sure I need to... I obviously have my own line to, you know, attend to. Nice meeting you, though.
Oh, come on. It looks like you tried to ruin the fun. Listen, we don't take no for an answer very easily. Come on, Rodney's got his very own special pickled egg pie and the foreman's down... Wait a minute. Where'd he go? Dadgummit. You know how hard it is to make friends up here? It gets pretty boring with just Eustace and Ralph.
And what am I? A roach?
I'm sorry. I forgot about you. You too. And Rodney as well. Now, only contemplation. What are we gonna do with these cars?
I can take them down.
Are you sure, little buddy? That switchback is pretty damn steep. One wrong move and you're toast. Why do you think me and Eustace work on that? We're the workhorses here at Redwood.
Me and Big Iron both made it up that entire incline just to get here. I think I can easily handle a switchback.
You did that with Big Iron! Wait!
The Redwood switchback is very steep, the steepest of all the hills they've went on. Wannabe's brakes aren't good, so I imagine what would happen after this heavy train is pushed by Wannabe right on down.
Wait, I don't have brakes! My brakes aren't working! Help!
I warned you!
Help!
You're going derail!
After the dust cleared, Wannabe was found hung up on by the couplers, and the entire train was on its side.
Oh, God dang it.
And to add insult to injury, here comes John Henry.
Well, 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 look who ended up on their side without taking an old engine's advice. You know, I may be stupid, but I ain't dumb. And I ain't stupid enough to not tell you to not go down that switchback. I tried telling you, but you drove off. What do you have to say for yourself, buddy?
Wannabe felt terrible.
I'm sorry, John Henry. I should have listened. Yet again, we could have stopped Big Iron before he drove off.
Well, at least you apologized. Come on. I'll get my driver to put you back on your wheels, and I'll pull you over to the works. We got some work to do.
A while later, all of the Kittsboro engines have returned to the station. But as they settled down to talk, a very worrisome Gary arrived.
Hello, Gary. How are you doing, lad?
Not very good.
We were expecting a wood load from John Henry and Eustace an hour ago. I was going up to see if they got into an accident or something.
Well, that's one thing you need to worry about. For a while now, I've been wondering where Wannabe has went.
You think this is like the mystery of the disappearing engines again? Aye, shut up, Dylan. That has been solved a while ago.
Maybe he went over to the mines to help Game Tez and Spitfire. I heard they always need new help.
Or maybe he went up to Redwood Logging to go and try to take the train himself.
Well, it seems like we'll just have to wait and see. They shouldn't be long.
Hey, look, over there.
It was John Henry. And pulling behind his load was Wannabe.
Delivery! Three logging disconnects, and a little flatbed that tried.
Aye, there you are. And I thought we possibly even lost you there. Aye, but you're pretty beat up, lad. Let's bring you into the works.
What happened, Wannabe?
I thought I could pull the Redwood supply train by myself because Big Iron left. Well, I guess I was wrong. I got damaged and towed down here.
Well, I guess the moral of the story here, folks, is don't get cocky. You never know when it's gonna bite you in the flatbed. That's right!
Ha 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 ha